science and art come together at Aalto University in Finland. Students produce an exhibition every other year in a course that blends mathematics and art.
So we were inspired by the ocean, and our mathematical inspiration was kind of transformation from 2D to 3D, geometrical to more organic.
So we have this kind of transformation or gradient in our piece. And our piece starts from a flat foldable pattern, and then it increases in volume, or elements are added to it that have like more volume, 3D volume. And also the patterns that we use in our piece, they have rotational and reflectional symmetry.
So our project is an algorithmically grown mathematical model that models the Physarum slime mold. We create an environment in which to grow the mold. There are some emitter points from which the particles come, and then start to search for the most straight path to the food points and follow each other's pheromone trails. And then they start creating these meshes of like optimal paths and creating these formations.
The frame is made of steel, so that was welded together. Of course, moving this piece requires modularity, so we had to do a frame that can like kind of slide in together. And then around that frame was we did the shell, which is the pink material that you see around. It was a chicken wire with a paper mache on it, and then a latex paint coat. And then the other piece is just simple stainless steel rods that were welded together into that shape.
During the course, we discovered this Miura Ori pattern, which is a certain type of paper tessellation, meaning that we use a flat piece of paper and fold it in a certain way. And the special thing about it is that it dramatically changes the properties of this, let's say, boring piece of paper and makes it into a material that is stiff on the one hand, but also flexible on the other hand, and can then be shaped using forces and counter forces. All the materials are renewable, it's natural yarn. We have the iron hooks are made out of old nails, and the rocks are just found in the forests of Nuuksio. So the whole piece has a very low carbon footprint and is very sustainable.
The name of our piece is Supernova, Remnant, Reimagined. And our goal was to create this like seemingly chaotic state that occurs after a supernova explosion. But we still wanted to have some sort of solid logic as to how we build the base. And here we were really inspired actually by fractals that are inherent to chaotic systems. So if you look closely at the base piece of the of our art, then you can see that it follows sort of a Julia set that is one type of fractal.
Well, I kind of was the visual person in our group, so I was thinking about more of the colors and the shapes. You can go around it, and every time you go in some different way, you can see it like from different point of view. So, yeah, that's that's the thing.
One of our inspiration sources was this British origami artist Richard Sweeney. He really helped us find our final form, which we evolved through the process.
Well, the whole piece consists of like two-dimensional basic geometrical shapes, and those are folded in a way that they make curves, and then they're attached. So, curves and geometrical shapes.
One of the things that we found interesting is that how a 2D plane could become 3D from curved folding.
We started off with something monsterish, but then we also had this idea of having something non-organic look a bit organic, which was like inspired from like a collection of cable cores that looks like a bit organic shape. But then we also got inspired from myceliums, mushrooms, and then we try to incorporate that in the math and the piece itself.
So it's called Olia, and it was intentionally made to be a bit vague, but it's like a space monster being thing. And it's based on Voronoi kind of math and made from metal and crocheted material and silicone.
It's an interdisciplinary art project where we try to incorporate both mathematics and art design into one thing. For us, it was trying to combine organic elements and abstract mathematics. We took a lot of inspiration from so-called pigeonhole principle, which is a mathematics statement that says that if you have less containers than you have things that you want to put on those containers, then you gotta put at least in one container more than one thing.
So this project is actually the outcome of a three-day workshop with Laura Isoniemi. We experimented with this tie and dye method, which is a very time-consuming method which requires a lot of patience and kind of artistic thinking.
So we're doing a black and white rainbow, which is very counterintuitive when you think of rainbows. The idea really is this definition of rhythm and frequency, which is a very maybe not mathematical, but at least physical idea.